Hey, welcome to the channel, everyone. Today, I decided we're going to start a mini-series. And in this mini-series, we're going to discuss all of the techniques that I use to make the gold that I make. And the reason we're going to do that is because I recently had a fella of mine reach out and say, "Hey, man, you just told me that you made a million gold. How'd you do it?" And I realized that the techniques that I was telling my friend, he was completely unaware of. So I thought I'd share it with the internet. So in this little mini web series, I encourage you to stick through each week as I post more details and more information on what I do and how I prepare all of the steps in order to make the gold. This is going to include things like setting up the auctioneer. This is going to include preparing beforehand, and this is going to include a very, very simple and lazy way to make the gold that I do. Again, my grand total was a little bit over a million gold in just under 60 days. So sit back, relax, take a look through my other gold making videos. Some of them are older, but they're still totally relevant and can make gold depending on your personal play style. And let's get into it. All right, so the first step in getting anything done and being successful at making gold is going to be getting yourself a set plan and a routine. The way that I do that is through organization of my data and information that I already have starting out the gate. So for example, I'm just going to use a notepad here. I've already got some things typed out. And here's just a very simple starting step. For this to work, you got to have two characters. Personally, make one of them a druid. Druids have historically been the best farmers all the way since Classic. Next step. I know for a fact I personally prefer herbalism and mining. I also know for a fact, especially after doing this for the last month, these are high turnover items, meaning I post them, they're going to sell quickly. So I'm going to make that the professions on both of the characters I choose to make. The next step is to make sure that I get an auction house or auctionator or some sort of an extra add-on for auctioning as quickly as I can. Because the last thing you want to do is waste a whole bunch of time playing around on the auction house when you could be out farming things for the gold. Next, spend 1 hour per day. Personally, I spent a little more than an hour because I was afforded that. Some days, I'm not afforded that. I do have a family, and whenever a family has certain needs that come up, they come first. Next, put your pets on the auction house. If you're not an avid pet fighter, farmer, collector, whatever the case is, if you're not the one collecting and leveling up, just go put them on the auction house. They're incredibly cheap. I think it's 4 silver for each one, and you'd be absolutely surprised, just like I was, at how expensive some of those are and how quickly some of them will sell for very high prices. And then finally, max your ass right for more gold. So these were my five or six different things that I knew I had to get in order to be successful in making any type of real gold on the auction house and have that kind of flow continuing. So with that, we're just going to kind of put this to the side. And this is the second step of organization. So just like the first step, I have to have some way of tracking what's successful and what's not. And in this, I chose to do an Excel sheet. Let's just go ahead and expand this out a little bit because I had some notes over here too. So not only that, but I'm also a big, I guess, promoter for getting to the next goal, getting to the next step, making it to that milestone. So every 8 days, I did put a little bit of a ticker to say where I'm at and how much gold I've made for the month so far. So over here we have the characters that I've played, the dates, the gold that they earned, and the hot items. This is really the only important part. Now that the data's done, I know that from last month I can go back and make gold off of these particular items, and they were successful heavy hitters last month, so I could try it again. Maybe I don't feel like it. Maybe I want to try something else. I can always do that too. But the key point is the historical data. I know for a fact that these items did sell. So we're going to scroll down here to that first mile marker of the 8th. I made 218,000 gold. That's far above my expectation of 16,000 per day by almost 11,000. We're going to scroll down a little bit further and we're going to see this little section here. This was a hard time for me. And the reason it was a hard time for me is because this is whenever the auction house went down. And it didn't come up for a while. Luckily, Blizzard fixed it. The milestone was a little bit skewed, only an extra 100,000. We had 218, we're up to 354. But then they fixed the auction house and I got my gold and here we go. 111,000 for that particular day because all the auctions hit. Okay? So that did put the next mile marker up by 536,000 gold for my total in 24 days. We're still well above my anticipated goal. And then finally down here at the bottom, we have the end of the month. And I managed to make just under 700,000 gold. And it was a massive increase from December 10th, whenever I had started this process, this organization, and figuring out what worked. And trust and believe, I went from everything from sitting in the same spot farming hyperspawn adds that dropped gold, hyperspawn adds that did skins, going through and doing old raids, going through and doing dungeons and transmog farms and the whole nine yards. Everything that they have on the internet, I at least gave it a solid effort between the month of December all the way through till the end of January. And through that effort, I managed to make 1,011,456 gold, keeping in mind that more than half of that was done after I had already tested those methods and they were not successful for my playstyle. So that's actually going to wrap up this little bit of a video. Again, it's going to be a mini series, so we're going to have quite a few of these videos popping through pretty quick. Eventually, it's going to be about once per week that I'm going to try to get these videos out so you guys can take a look at different progress and see where I'm at, see where you're at. We can talk about it. I'm going to drop my Discord link in the description below so you can join my Discord, excuse me, and see all the progress that my brother and I have made. And then on the next video, we're going to talk about TSM, how to set it up, what I do for it, and hopefully you'll be able to pick that up and sell and distribute just as quickly and easily as I can every day. So until then, we'll see you all next time.